It's time now for our daily science segment. Today, we're looking at a potential breakthrough in the fight against Alzheimer's. For the first time, a drug appears to show a slowdown in the effects of the disease. Now, initial results have been confirmed by a large-scale trial. The rate of cognitive decline was slowed by 27%. To discuss France 24's Shirley Sitbon is with me here in the studio now. And Shirley, tell us first of all how this drug functions and how it does slow cognitive decline.
Well, to understand that, we need to see how Alzheimer's disease works, what happens in your brain. Well, it all started, it was detected for the first time about 100 years ago when Professor Alzheimer's had this patient who had this strange symptoms, which he described. She had memory losses, hallucinations, confusion, and then her behavior became more and more aggressive. As time went on, everything intensified. All of these symptoms, and then she died at an early age, just 5 years later at 55. When she died, they carried out an autopsy and realized that in her brain there were plaques. That's how it all started. Well, years later, we can see this illustration that shows what happens in the brain. There are key proteins. And somebody who suffers from Alzheimer's disease, well, those key proteins just multiply. And basically, this leads to the death of just brain cells. This is a brain of a person who has Alzheimer's. So you see, they all multiply. And this is a brain of somebody who is healthy. And there's just a few of these proteins. So what this drug does, it's an antibody. It destroys, it tells the immune system to destroy these extra proteins, not all of them, but these extra proteins which cause the death of brain cells. So the effects are impressive, as you've said. We can see another graphic which shows that, well, for example, for a person, the test in the clinical trial was carried out at some 1,800 people. Those who had the placebo, they declined from state A to B in 12.7 months. But people who did take the medication, well, they declined in a period of 18 months. So this shows that the progression of the disease was slowed down, which is quite extraordinary.
Yeah, good news, certainly, Shirley. There are some side effects worth noting as well, though. But the death rate is roughly the same in the group that took this drug you're talking about and in the one that had the placebo.
Yes, cases of cerebral hemorrhage. A case like that, 17% of the people who took the drug had that. And the people who in the placebo group, just 9%. So there's a real difference. Also, cerebral edema, 12.6% of the people who took the drug, well, they suffered those. Only 1.7% of the placebo group. So experts point out that there are very significant secondary effects, and this has to be noted, of course, and followed.
All right, Shirley Sitbon, our science editor, thanks very much indeed.